Thank you.
Do you ever have a watch where it's just like, you can't quite get the, it's like too loose or it's too tight? You guys ever have that? It's a huge deal. Oh, I think I got it. Okay. Thanks a lot, guys, for coming out. I know a few of you, and I'm glad about that, because quite frankly, Phoenix audiences are known as the most ruthless audiences in the world. The most incidents of audience killing performer ratio is definitely hooked on Phoenix. Hooked on Phoenix is a program started by a few children to kind of promote the awareness of performer assault by dissatisfied audiences. And I'm proud to sign up for one of the sponsors. You just have to sponsor by signing up. There's really nothing else that I have to do besides that. But I am happy to serve that, because too many people have died. A lot of people have died this year. A lot of people. And that's not usual. Usually a lot less people die. But this year, tons and tons of people just were like, what? A lot of daddies. Okay? Now, as we know, pretty much every single dead person, I'm sure some of us know some dead people, every single dead person is immediately repurposed into a different form of molecular energy, and and hopefully they won't fuck up next time. And the thing is, like, I know a lot of us are like, I don't want to die. You know, a lot of us are. Some people are like, well, but here's the deal. How many of you guys have ever come close to death? Anybody? Come close to death? Okay. Got a few people over here. Maybe, do I have anybody over here at all? Okay, that's interesting. How about you guys over here? This little section? This section is like this untouchable. It's like nothing has happened to us. Ever. It's pretty intense, right? Like experience, but you're like, but afterwards you kind of have like that new perspective. You're like, well, I got so many things to do. Baby, I love you so much. And but like, baby, I just realized I actually don't love you. I need to get out of this relationship. I'm so sorry I wasted so much of our time. But it's good. And I think, like, how many of you guys have actually technically been dead and then came back? Anybody? Two people? There's like some people like, I don't know if I can count that. No, online gaming does not count, but it's an interesting place, isn't it? That place when you die? Because after watching Flatliners, you know, it's a great movie, you know, about a bunch of people that, you know, medical students that purposefully, you know, make themselves dead and then kind of revive themselves after, you know, a certain amount of time. They tried to outdo each other. And when I died once, I'll tell you, this is a quick story about what I saw. And this is something that we can all expect, hopefully. It was a winter night. It was in Montana. I was visiting from Seattle after recently having moved there from high school, so I was probably about 21. Maybe 22. I had drank about 5 to 6 ounces of Robitussin DM, like I used to do in high school. And as we all know, drinking Robitussin DM gets you really, really fucking high. Like, really high. Super high. Like heroin high, essentially. It's like a, you know, they do call it poor man's heroin. And it is pretty economical, if you think about it. But, you know, so I drank that, and I just remember getting higher and higher, and I hadn't done it in a while, so I forgot, like, how high you actually do get. And I kept going. like more than usual, and I just needed a break, you know, from the group of kids that were in the basement watching Star Trek The Next Generation. So I went upstairs into my car and didn't start it up, just got in the car, and this was below zero. It was definitely below zero out. It was like that. It was like so cold. You guys probably don't remember this, but there are places where it's cold. It gets really cold. Imagine as hot as it gets here, it can get that cold. Okay, so like when you're breathing, it's just like, you know, like just like ice crystals. I'm looking like an Arctic explorer already, with my mustache is already just fused with ice in it, and I've only been outside for a few minutes. But so I was in the car, I didn't have it started. I was listening to, I think, This Mortal Coil, which is a great band you should check out on 480 Records. I think you'll enjoy it. I was listening to This Mortal Coil, and I was staring at a streetlight. So my car was parked in an alley, below freezing. I had gloves on and stuff, and a hat and a scarf. And I was staring at this light, and then suddenly the light started growing longer, like a little bit longer and longer. And then it started looking like a doorway in a way, like kind of a doorway. And I just remember it slowly like getting larger, and I was like, I could just like, maybe I'll just go through that doorway. And the music was awesome, you know. And I started to feel like I was like, oh yeah, I'm moving. I didn't know if I was moving or if it was moving. And then I felt like I was in a place that I can't really remember color-wise. But I do remember thinking to myself, I remember this. I remember thinking that, but then I got scared about it. I was like, wait a minute, I shouldn't be remembering this. And then I realized, oh my God, I think I might be like freezing to death. And as soon as that thought hit, I just was like trying to struggle to regain like consciousness. And then I realized, oh yeah, I can't feel my fingers. You know, I was in a car, definitely in a car. The windows were like crystallized. And I could barely move. And so I just remember having to like use all my strength to like open up the door and slowly almost crawl, but I was staggering, holding on to things, going through my friend's backyard with all the frozen things everywhere, and finally getting to the back door and then opening up the door. And my friend's going, what's wrong? I was like, And then they led me downstairs and sat me on a couch, and they covered me with tons of blankets, and then they sat on top of me. My friend sat on top of me while I was watching Picard. Talking about some shit. Worf, is it true that... Captain, it's not clear, but it is... It's stuff like that. You know, stuff about things not being clear. Kind of new particle technology. Diverting energy to different shields. But, and I remember coming to... and thinking to myself, you know what? If people have to do stuff, and if they think that things are better, then how many of those people do you know are there for the first time? And when did they decide that everybody that's ever been has been that one guy, right? Because if you think about it, ain't no two people the same, like a footprint, you know what I'm saying? You can try. But it gives a general idea. But you can't do this, because general idea is always waiting for you after Colonel, good luck. Now, Lieutenant, I won't be there, is a good guy to know. All of these technologies you see here on stage, and I don't want to exaggerate too much, but all of these technologies that you see here on stage,
it's on Second Avenue. Yeah.
Are real? It's not just a bunch of like carved out stuff or metal frames, you know, and sound engineer back there playing, press and play. You know, the stuff makes sounds. Okay?
Prove it!
Like that. Okay? All the fun stuff. All these things make noises, okay? Okay, that's just to prove that this is not fake. These two. Even here. Okay, so this is my first song. This is an ode to Phoenix. Now, Phoenix is when you're flying over an airplane and you're looking at Phoenix and you're seeing all these like communities with water center. This poem is built on fake water. Weird kind of amoeba shapes, you know, it's like, oh, it's organic. It's like, man, this is a lake. It's totally here. Just remember this. For every person that has a swimming pool, two people. If every person had a swimming pool, wouldn't life be awesome? I can't remember it. Anyways, here we go. This is it. This is the song. Here we go.
I'm not afraid.
Coming out my new album, and you should go check that out.